In our previous video, we created a chart, and in this video we're going to take a look at how you format that chart once you've got it created. And again, this is similar to Excel. First of all, just click on the chart and the handles will appear around it, and we'll get these buttons over here, and let's click on chart elements, and it lets us determine whether we want to have a title or not. And we've got some options about where we want to put it, and that's probably not where we want it. And let's look at some other options here. And we can give it a fill color and a border. I don't think that's a big deal with a title. This stuff is not really a big deal with a title either, nor is this. You know, you can mess with the alignment. You know, you can rotate a little bit, but let's just close that. Let's go back here and go to our chart title and click on our options again. Let's just put it above the chart. I think it looks the best there. Now, you know, if you don't like it there, you can get your four-headed arrow and you can pretty much move it any place you want to anyway. So I'm going to undo that and get it back so it's centered over the top like that. And let's go to our paintbrush here, and this gives us some options for styles and colors. So if I pick a different color palette here, and I really don't like the monochromatic ones at all because they're all basically different shades of the same color. And if you do have a legend, although you know you frequently don't have a legend with a pie chart, it just makes it hard to read. You know, you've got four shades of purple, and then you got to try to figure out which shade of purple this is down here. So I think you're better off with the colorful options up here, and we'll just leave it with the original. And then for style here, and let's scroll down a little bit further, see what else we get for options. And you know, what I'd kind of like is one with everything around the edges, but I would also like to have the numbers. I really don't like legends with a pie chart because you have to go back and forth. Now there we go, but everything's the same color. That's not really, doesn't look all that cool either. So let's just go back to our original here, and then we've got an option over here for funneling or filtering. And if you don't want to see everything in the chart, you can turn some of it off, but I don't think that's going to happen very often. If you don't want the data in the chart, you probably just wouldn't select it in the first place. Now, what I really want to have when I do a pie chart is I don't want to have the legend down here. You can click on it and hit the delete key and make it go away, but now you've got a totally worthless chart. But if I right click on the chart and go to add data labels and add data labels here, it'll put the numbers there for me. If I right click again and I go to, let me see, format data series. That's not what I wanted. I wanted format data labels. And here we go. And these are always kind of confusing. Is it the series name or is it the category name? And I think it's the category name here, but they both sound pretty similar to me. I'm going to turn on the category name and it will give me a label and a value, and that's pretty much what I wanted. And you've got some other options here, you know, that you can turn on and off. But these are the big ones. We want the value. Sometimes you want the percentage instead of the value. In this case, it's the same, so the percentage would be kind of redundant. And if you want to move, you know, these labels, just, you know, get your four-headed arrow and come on. Let's try that again. Yeah, it's not moving for me there. There we go. It's a little touchy on this stuff sometimes. Let's try to move it. And we'll take this one and we'll try to move it. And there we go. So let's move that down a little bit lower. Okay. So you can pretty much customize it any way you want to, just like you could in Excel.